I'll just say this as an editorial comment. It's a fact that NIH, which has been the major funder of biomedical research, which is the major funder of biomedical research in the world, has basically pulled the plug on clinical research support in general as a general area of emphasis. The infrastructure for doing good nutritional studies in particular has relied on a mechanism that is now being withdrawn due to funding constraints, and it's affecting our ability to do good nutritional research. So we have to rely on other sources, when we rely on industry, I've done a lot of work that's sponsored by the National Dairy Council. I'll say that, you know, and acknowledge as a disclosure, but they haven't told me what to find. They haven't, you know, they didn't tell me that my first study was going to come up with a completely opposite result from what I expected, and nothing I've done since then has been dictated by the dairy industry, but they've been very good about funding the work because we've been able to show that saturated fat is not as maybe the evil agent of doom that has been it's been made out to be. Others have shown that when saturated fat is packaged in a dairy product, particularly a fermented dairy product, there may actually be some metabolic benefits. So we've been on a sort of a parallel course, not because they've told me what to do, but because we've been very interested in pursuing work that really, I think, justifies a somewhat more relaxed approach to consuming dairy fats than has been generally recommended. Having said that, you know, I think that the sponsorship for research of this scale has to come from other sources. So I'm, you know, very glad that I'm involved in an advisory role to some such work that's going on, funded through philanthropy. And I think that's one of the best ways to do research of the type we're talking about is through philanthropic support. But we still, I personally have not yet gotten to the point where I see the potential for doing these large studies with the kind of support we need. And as you say, I think it's really important that we figure out ways of getting that support.
Well, you've certainly pioneered much of the research on that has changed the way the public thinks about, you know, cholesterol and you know, LDL cholesterol in particular, and also the foods we eat and how the foods we eat affect cholesterol. And it's becoming more and more popular now that saturated fats aren't the culprit to heart disease.
As such.
Whole sorting. Yes.
As such.